welcome everybody. This is the concert, The Sound World of Carlo Dolci. I'm very excited to be hosting this tonight. My name is Meredith Luke, and I'm the curator of academic programs here at the Davis Museum. I am one of the co-sponsors of this event along with Claire Fontaine, who is my colleague I will introduce in just a minute. Before I do, I just wanted to make sure that I thanked the Edna Virginia Moffitt Fund of the Medieval and Renaissance Studies program that has supported this concert tonight. And I have just three reminders. I'm sure you've anticipated, but I'm going to say it anyway. If you could kindly turn off your cell phones and the things that make noise that are in your pockets and purses. There will be a short 15-minute intermission in the middle, and you'll have a chance to look around more at the art or use the facilities. And I also wanted to let you know that there will be a reception after the concert upstairs, so you can join us afterwards for some snacks and some wine, or whatever happens you would like. With that, I'm going to bring up my colleague Claire Fontaine, who is the Phyllis Henderson Perry Professor and Chair of the Music Department here at Wellesley College.
This is a very special night at the museum. I was thinking of recoining that phrase for us tonight in this sort of salon or academy environment that we're privileged to be part of. Inspired by the exquisite exhibit of Dolci's artwork, tonight the musicians will create a sound space for 17th century Florence. Like the well-traveled paintings for the exhibit, the musicians have come together to honor the meticulous work of Carlo Dolci, and I've thought of them as a kind of impromptu ensemble Dolci. The music of the Seicento holds the quintessence of the Baroque, where the intention of voice and instrument alike was to evoke powerful emotions. The lush and vivid colors of Dolci's paintings provide visual analogs for these emotions. One of the most glorious pairings of the program tonight is Mary's Lullaby by Tarquinio Merula, Or che tempo di dormire, that is in the first half of the program. And this is beautifully paired with the three paintings that are before you of the Virgin and Child. Tonight's rare marriage of music and art is sure to flood your senses. Please join me now in welcoming soprano Lori Monahan with instrumentalists Catherine Liddell and Laura Yepesen.
So Such a journey through poetry, this particular program, too. The piece we just did was very inspired by the gesture of the word, and that was part of the Florentine Camerata at that point in time. They argued fiercely about rhythm versus the rhythm of the text. And now we'll journey into what is more motivated by rhythm.
Thank you.
As Claire mentioned, this next piece is framed by these gorgeous paintings of the Madonna and Child. And this particular piece is perhaps any parent's total nightmare, and that is being able to see into the future. Because what she does, she's holding her child, and then she flashes forward into what's going to happen to him, sort of piece by piece.
Thank you. Thank you.
So nice to see you all reading the texts. They are bad words, a broken tradition here, but the poetry is so inspiring. And in this piece, hang on, it's not a direct drive.
Thank you.
Throughout his whole life, and after her death, he wrote this poem. And he was an older man, and probably many of us feel this way about early loves that we had. If only we'd had the poetry and the words that we have in older age that we didn't have as a young person. So he laments the fact that he was not an evolved enough poet.
Thank you.
Cicadas in Greece, they make such a noise. And when I found this piece by Landi, I thought, oh, yeah, it reminded me of those hot summer nights.
Simone, cantando. rhythm.
Last one is about the journey we're all on together. We all are headed there. Nobody's gotten out of it yet, so we might as well party on the way.